specific mission I am on this ride, and that is to give you all who are hoping to start a channel, hoping to start moto vlogging, those of you who have maybe thought about it but aren't quite sure and just need that little extra push to get started, I'm gonna give you my biggest tips on starting your very own moto vlog channel of your own. And without further ado, let's just jump right in because I think this video will hit home with quite a few of you. So let's just jump right into it. Now, first of all, if you thought about making a channel, you've probably done some research already. So I'm not going to go into great detail. This is more for those of you who are just getting started. And these tips are going to be like the very foundation of you starting a motovlog. So first of all, starting off a motovlog. My number one thing with this is you gotta be safe. I've got a stand set up here where I've got a camera here, and I've got a camera here facing me. I didn't start out this way because when I first started, I wanted to make sure that me being on the bike and talking and making videos wasn't going to distract me from my first duty on the motorcycle, which is to be safe and to be a responsible rider. So that is first and foremost, is before you get started, make sure you're a seasoned rider. When I say seasoned rider, what I mean is you want to be able to be comfortable on your bike. You don't want to get out there and, you know, not be confident in your skills and then get out here and have one more thing to distract you from being a safe, defensive, and aware rider. So that's my number one. Number two, this is the biggest thing I think about starting new moto vlogs, and I've seen a couple people have workarounds to this, but this is a big deal, and that is have good audio. Now, if you've watched the 333, he started out as Tooch. He's from Jersey, I think. But he started off his moto vlogs by getting out there with the camera and just riding. And then afterwards, in post, he would add commentary so that he had good audio. And I think more so than getting out here and having a mic live as you ride is to make sure that you can be understood, that you don't have all this crazy wind noise, that you don't have distortion from your own voice or from your bike. You want to be able to understand you, and you want to be able to get across what it is you're trying to get across on your video. And if that audio is preventing you from doing that, then you gotta start from there. Now my third tip here is absolutely important, and all these tips are gonna be important and carry some weight to it, but this one here is uber important, and that is edit, edit, edit. Now, if you're starting your own moto vlog and you think you're just gonna get out here, turn the camera on, ride and talk, get home, upload all your video to your computer, and then shoot all of that video straight to YouTube, then you've got another thing coming. Because just posting the video that you recorded as a stream of video without editing, it gets harder and harder to watch. And I will tell you this, I've watched newer moto vloggers do this, where they just upload like 45 minutes of video, and so much of it is just frankly not interesting, that it gets harder to watch. And I'll give new moto vloggers a break for a while, but it's so important to edit your videos. Cut out the parts where there's long silences. Now, if you're somebody who's just getting out there and getting the experience of riding, that's different. But if you're a moto vlogger, which is somebody who's gonna get out there, you know, talk about something, have a point to their video, then you wanna make sure that the bulk of the video is what you're trying to get across, and that is not you just silently writing. So edit your videos, you know, if you wanna put in some music, do that. You know, if you've got an intro that you've prepped, that you got B-roll that you want to add as you go along, yeah, there's lots of stuff to it. There's more to a channel than just recording yourself riding and then slapping it on YouTube. You know, like I said, if you're just getting started, try new things. Try adding music. You know, try putting your camera from a different angle. And I'll admit, myself, I've toyed with the idea of putting one of my cameras, maybe facing, like the engine or the rear of the bike close to the engine. But, you know, because I don't want to make things stagnant, but I try to keep things fresh with content, so hopefully I'm serving that purpose. Now, my fourth thing here is that you've got to practice.
What are we talking about? Practice?
Now, not everything that I record on my cameras is going to make it to YouTube. I'll record a whole video, like a whole subject. I'll get home and, I just don't like it. Maybe I don't like the way it turned out. Maybe there was just something about my voice that day that I didn't like, and it never makes it to the channel. And that you can just chalk up to practice. You've got to practice your craft, and if you want to make videos on YouTube, you've got to practice. If that means maybe before you get out on the road and talking, and maybe doing a dry run while you're parked, or in your living room or something, go for it. But you got to get used to talking, and you got to get used to multitasking, because you're not always going to just be able to get on the bike and ride and talk. If I'm in traffic, like if I'm on the highway and I'm trying to motor vlog and I'm lane splitting and having to worry a lot about what's going on the road, then you'll notice, if you've seen any videos like that before of mine, that it gets kind of choppy and harder to listen to. So, like I said, you gotta practice. You gotta put yourself in the live situations that you're gonna be facing when you get out there and you start motor vlogging. Now, my fifth thing here is something that I didn't do till late in the game, it would seem, for my channel. And that's get involved. And I see a lot of new and upcoming motor vloggers doing this, and it's great. Hey, buddy. What I mean by get involved is get out there on other people's, on other motor vloggers' videos. Get out there on Instagram. Leave comments on people's Instagram, on Twitter. Leave comments in other people's videos. Get on a live stream. I think live streams are great because people are actively participating in live streams. So you're going to get people paying attention to who's there. And it's an easy way to get your name out there quickly, is to get out there and participate. Get involved in the motor vlogging community. That's really what it's become. There's a lot of motor vloggers out there. And if you want to get in on the game, you got to get involved. My sixth thing here, doesn't carry as much weight, but you want to keep track of your viewer engagement. Now, let's say maybe your videos are only getting, a dozen views or 25 views, but if out of those 25 views, you've got 10 comments, that is a good thing. When people are involved with your channel and are engaged with your channel, they're going to stick around. If you have a lot of views and not a lot of people commenting on your videos, those are the kind of subscribers that will come and go. And I'm definitely one of those that can have quite a few views, but not a whole lot of comments. So you want to make sure that you're getting engaged, you're watching and keeping track of your viewer engagement. And you want to get engaged as well. If someone leaves a comment, make sure that you go back and you leave a comment on that person's comment or reply to that person's comment, because that'll bring them back. Trust me, if they know that you're participating actively on your channel and that you're paying attention to what people have to say about your videos, they'll stick around. Now, the last thing here that I will tell you, and this is something that's really important about motor vlogging, because a lot of the times you're gonna get started, it's gonna be frustrating, your subscriber base might not seem like it's kicking into gear, you're stuck below 100 subscribers, but just stick with it. And my last tip here isn't to stick with it, but it is to have fun. Because if you're not having fun, you're not gonna stick with it. It's gonna get frustrating, and if you don't like doing it, then you'll stop. And I see a lot of channels that only last so long because people get frustrated. They keep at it for 3 or 4 months, and it doesn't seem like there's a lot of people that want to watch your videos, but you gotta be stick with it and you gotta be consistent. But most of all, you've gotta have fun while you're doing it, because if it's not fun, then why are you doing it? You know, part of it is that motor blocking is inherently fun because you're out here on your bike, and that's just fun all by itself. But it's a lot of work to have a channel. You know, you've gotta edit, you've gotta post, you gotta keep track of things, and you know, you wanna get on a regular schedule, so there's a lot to it. So you've gotta keep in mind that if you're not having fun, then I would never dissuade you from creating content. But if it's not fun to you, then maybe rethink. Maybe motor vlogging's not for you. Maybe take that investment that you've made in the equipment and try something else. You know, there's a lot of things you can do with a GoPro and a YouTube account. Alright guys, that is all I got for you today. I love the motor vlogging community, and I think it's great that so many people are looking to get into the game. Look at me sounding all like I know what I'm talking about. But, you know, I love that there are more and more people getting involved, because the more and more people who are getting involved in motor vlogging creators, that's just more people who are out there actually watching and paying attention to what's going on out here. And that's good for all of us. But guys, I appreciate you watching. I appreciate all of you subscribers out there that tune into my videos all the time. You know who you are. And hopefully I can get a few of you to tune in more regularly as well. Make sure if you like this video that you hit a thumbs up down there, which is the like button. And if you haven't already, smash that subscribe button. Yeah, let's not end this video riding into the sun.